Welcome to our coverage of the Nations Cup 2013. It's the World Cup of match racing and it's happening right here in Middelfart in Denmark. 13 men's crews and 4 women's crews from 11 different countries will go head to head until a men's and women's champion is crowned on Saturday night. And to cap it all, we're in one of the most beautiful parts of the world, the Triangle region of Denmark, made up of 6 municipalities that have come together to host and support this year's Nations Cup.
Well, a lot of things are special about the Triangle region. Of course, we are in the middle of Denmark. All roads meet here. We have harbors, we have airports, etc. So we have a lot of infrastructure, a lot of people mingling together in the Triangle region. And that means that we have an environment that is very dynamic and very entrepreneurial. Well, in the Triangle region of Denmark, we are actually all entrepreneurs. And match racing, and Nations Cup, good examples, very good examples of entrepreneurship. Of course, we want to support this kind of initiative that brings the Triangle region to the world and the world to the Triangle region.
Lay me down into the sea. The crews all race identical boats, so there's no advantage at the start. What will decide the winner is the skill of the sailors and how they read the race course. So what conditions can they expect here on the water? This is where
I want to be. I think we should expect some light wind tomorrow for the first round of the qualification. And then the breeze is going to pick up, so it's going to be a bit stronger Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Saturday should look really good. So for those teams who are in the semi-finals and finals on Saturday, they're going to have some breeze. It's a bit shifty wind coming down all the time and a lot of current running in here, so it's a bit tricky waters, but it's good. It's good racing and it's close to the shore, so it's good stadium sailing. I think there's a lot of strong teams here, and all the teams can get around the course nicely and make it work. So it's whoever got a good day and sort out the tricky shift and figure out how to get quickest around it. A lot of teams can do well, so I think there's going to be some strong competition.
This is where I want to be. Lay me down into the sea. Well, the opening ceremony certainly got off with a big bang, but this is the ISAF Nations Cup Grand Final, powered by the Triangle region, and that means the serious business gets underway on the water tomorrow with the round robins. And on Thursday, Frederik, the Crown Prince of Denmark, will be in action alongside Danish sailing legend Jesper Bank. So there's lots and lots to look forward to. We'll be live streaming throughout the day. And of course, at the end of each day, we'll bring you highlights and reaction too. So we'll see you for those. Bye for now.